Now, I would like to ask His Excellency Mr. Jaime Mayor Oreja, former Minister of Interior of Spain, former Vice President of the European People's Party Group in the European Parliament, to deliver his speech.
Mr. Prime Minister, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your invitation. I am going to try to define my position about this phenomenon. But when dealing with a social phenomenon, a challenge, a problem, our first obligation is to place it in its context, in the general framework that presides over a society. Immigration is no exception, and the first thing we have to do is to diagnose the society in which we live. Dealing with an immigration phenomenon, when society is not going through a crisis, is not the same as dealing with it when it reaches a critical point, its peak, its maximum expression. In these circumstances, it adds to the complexity of the immigration phenomenon itself the severity of the crisis in which we live. We must dedicate as much time to one as the other when dealing with immigration. The crisis we are experiencing in Europe is not exclusively political, economic, or financial. We are facing a more profound, misdiagnosed crisis of a cultural nature, a crisis of truth, of civilization, of personal attitude, in short, of the person. Today and tomorrow, not only do we have to face up to the immigration phenomenon itself as a challenge, but at the same time, we have to face up to our European cohesion crisis, which is the consequence of a growing loss of permanent references. I dare say that tackling the latter is even a necessary precondition in a crisis of values in the plural. The first manifestation of the crisis is of valor of the individual. Consequently, speaking, generally speaking, the first thing is to eradicate the lack of courage, the fear, the reverential fear of a dominant trend in the political, cultural and media spheres, which is to a large extent the cause of the crisis. Let us not deceive ourselves. Let us not start the house from the roof. We will not have a common immigration policy if we are not capable of regenerating, refounding, and renewing, as you wish, the European Union. But regeneration and renewal in values, not only in specific policies, in mere instruments. Europe demands reconciliation in values among ourselves, the Europeans. Exactly the same way when Sarkozy and the Pope Benedict decided together defend laïcité positive some years ago. The phenomenon of immigration will worsen. It will become the European problem per excellence if we are not capable of strengthening internal cohesion, shared European values, the spiritual dimension, the European soul. Because the European Union, the European community, that of the founding fathers, was born with a lot of soul and spirit and little body. 70 years later, we find ourselves with a lot of body, many institutions, but little soul, no spirit. European regeneration is not possible without rectification, only with good intentions. We have to diagnose where we made a mistake, why in recent decades there has been an unhealthy obsession in many resolutions, in many European parliamentary initiatives, in many directives, an effort to destroy and replace European Christian values. What I am saying, I can assure you, is not an exaggeration. 10 years of experience in the European Parliament are proof of this. Above all, however, Viktor Orban's strength and courage in defending these values is the main cause of his difficulties within the Union, beyond the false pretext that many people say. Thank you very much, Viktor, for your courage and for your strength defending our Christian values. Today, there is only talk of the economy, of a new technological revolution. It is true, the economy is essential. The new times are a reality, but the economy, being indispensable for the emergence of democracy, for there to be European middle classes, for a certain moment onwards, does not cohere, but perhaps makes us more competitive. Cohesion, an essential element in tackling the challenge of immigration, such as new technological advance, will only come hand in hand with values, convictions, principles, respect for human nature and reason. Use the terms as you wish, in short, the person. The European Union must have a common immigration policy. I believe in the European Union. I am convinced that despite the current difficulties, it is an irreplaceable union in order to face our future, and a union of truth and from truth. However, this requires an urgent correction, which I have just mentioned. A common policy essentially requires legality, a common European border, the same policies or migratory flows, the same control, even a common border police. One of the manifestations of the seriousness of the crisis, as Fabrice Haddock explains in his book, The Fortune of Being Born in Our Time, is that the most difficult thing is to defend the obvious. The more obvious, the more difficult to defend, because the obvious needs no demonstrations. The importance of legality, obvious. The rigor linked to the concept of the border, obvious. The need to take the Union to the border, obviously very difficult to defend. But being essential, the criteria of legality in immigration is not sufficient in the face of arbitrariness, which unfortunately has been too present. We also need to share the moral strength of a European project. Only projects based on moral strength have the necessary political ambition, and that lack is the cause of what is happening to us, of the current lack of ambition. When few, quite of a few, or many, have tried to socialize nothingness from on the elimination of permanent references, trying to create a new world order, an order is being destroyed, which has led us to a disorder. We don't move from one particular order to another, but to disorder. Europe today is not presided over by the extreme left or the extreme right, but extreme disorder. Extreme disorder is incompatible with an orderly immigration policy, which is the only possible one. In the same way, that disorder does not culminate in disorder, but that disorder is usually the antechamber of violence. Today, urban violence. Ladies and gentlemen, last February, the 23rd of February in Paris, in the French Senate, the Federation One of Us that I chair, which brings together European organizations that defend life, launched a cultural platform that unites thinkers and intellectuals on a manifesto prepared by the French philosopher and great thinker Rémi Brague under the title For a Europe Loyal to Human Dignity. Europe, more than a strictly political debate, faces a cultural challenge in which at the heart of it is the conception that we all have of the nature of the person, in short, of human dignity. The current distortion, the naturalization of the human person who presides over our policies is incompatible with a common policy on immigration, which we so desperately need. To this end, we must be able to liberate the intelligences of Europeans from a dominant cultural trend. Thank you very much.